शुरू। ओके टुडे विल बी स्टडीइंग कनेक्शनिस्ट मॉडल। ओके एंड इन द इन दिस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर वी विल बी सीइंग टुडे हॉफिन नेटवर्क। हॉफिन नेटवर्क इज अ एग्जांपल ऑफ कनेक्शनिस्ट मॉडल। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल सी व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कनेक्शनिस्ट मॉडल। एज यू सी दिस इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ अ हॉफिन नेटवर्क व्हिच इज अगेन एन एग्जांपल ऑफ कनेक्शनिस्ट मॉडल। कनेक्शनिस्ट मॉडल वर्क्स ऑन द कांसेप्ट ऑफ न्यूरल नेटवर्क्स मीनिंग artificial intelligence always tries to make a computer work like a human. It will try to simulate work is going on, it will try to simulate a human brain. It will not try to duplicate a human brain, but it will take the neurons that are present in a human brain, fine, and it will try to inspire from those neurons and try to work similar, fine. So this is an example of a Hoffman network. Now, Hoffman network is a neural network which works on the theory of memory. Now, what does it comprise of basically? It comprises of processing elements. These are called as processing elements. These are all processing elements. And they are either in an active state or inactive state. This indicates that it is an active state and this indicates that it is an inactive state. Are connected to each other and there is a weight associated with it. The weight is either a negative or a positive. Now, what does this negative or positive weight signify? Let us see how it works, how this whole thing works. Fine? Now, whenever how this particular Hoffman network works, we start from any particular random processing element. Suppose this is the processing element we take. What we try to find is, are there any processing elements which are connected to this particular processing element in an active state? If you find this particular element is in an active state. So, whatever are the weights associated with this active state processing elements, the sum of these weights is calculated. Let us calculate. There are two things that are coming to mind now. One is this minus 1 and the one is this plus 3. So, plus 3 and minus 1 makes up 2. So it is a positive thing. So if it is a positive element, what it will try to do is, it will try to make, if this is a positive weight, it will try to activate this. And if it is a negative, it will try to deactivate this particular processing element. Now let us see over here. The addition is plus 2. This is a positive weight, so it will activate. And since this is a negative, it will deactivate this. This is how it works. And again, take any element in random. Let us say I take this particular element. Now when I take this processing element, okay, again, there is one active processing element associated with it. Calculate the sum. This is plus 2 and plus 1, that is 3. And there is a positive weight over here. So this will be active. This is how it works. And it will continue to go on working in the same way until it reaches to a state where no processing element is in a position to change the other processing element. This particular state is called as a stable state, and this particular state is also called as parallel relaxation. It is called as parallel relaxation. Now when we consider one network, like this is the network we started with. This is the network we started with. When we think of this particular network, we can choose any of the random elements, and the parallel relaxation state of this particular Hoffman network might be 2, 3 or 4. It need not necessarily be one stable state. There might be 4 states wherein different processing elements are active and it is a stable state. So one Hoffman network might have many stable states, that is what I mean to say. So now what is the use of this particular Hoffman network and what are the features of this? As we saw, this Hoffman network is based on the theory of memory. These are certain features of this Hoffman network. One is the distributed representation. Second, it is distributed asynchronous control, which deals with the local and global state, content addressable memory, and fault tolerance. Now we will understand these features one by one. Let us say distributed representation. Now, the Hopfield network will be used to represent memory with the help of various patterns of this particular processing elements. A certain pattern will represent one memory, another pattern will represent different set of memory. So this is a distributed representation. And based on what is the state of one processing element, the other processing element is going to get its state. Okay. Now what do you understand by distributed asynchronous control? Okay. Each time when we speak about any random unit, it will try to see to it that it is in a locally optimum state. Okay. Locally it is at the best state with respect to the other processing elements. And so on. Since it looks into the local thing, one unit looks at the local optimum, it gets the global optimum. Next is the content addressable memory. As we saw, different patterns will give us different memory. Fine. So when we put a certain pattern, for example, when we put this particular pattern, something like this, it will try to get a stable state which is closest to this particular pattern, and it will rewrite that particular pattern. Fine. And fault tolerance. Since each unit is going to depend on another unit for its local and global optimum, it will see to it that even if one unit fails, okay, the whole network perform properly. So that is why it is fault tolerant. Now let us see one of the stable states of this particular network. Okay, so first of all, we'll pick up some random unit. Let us say this is the network.
And if we go on, we would arrive at three or four stable states.